Hi guys, today I'm going to be showing you a new collection from Beauty Bar Baby. I was sent this in PR, and I actually have some stuff from Beauty Bar Baby in the past. I have some of their multi-chrome flakes, and I loved those last year. I used those so much, actually the year before. It's now 2021. I'm filming this in 2020. But like a year ago, I would use those all the time, and I keep forgetting about them, but anyway. She sent me the Glowtastic collection, and it contains shadows as well as nail polishes. So these are the eyeshadows. There are seven kind of neon-y shimmers, but they're almost a little bit on the sheer sort of toppery glittery side. They remind me a little bit of the Shine by SD shadows. These are beautiful. I have played with these already once, and I will show you a picture of the look that I did, and I really liked how these came out. And I'm also going to show you the nail polishes, which it's really cool because basically the collection is the same colors in the nail polishes. Well, I almost dropped one. The same colors in the nail polishes as in the shadows. So I just think that this is very interesting and unique and fun and different. And I have tried the nail polishes on my nails, is what I'm wearing today. And I have to admit though that they're not my favorite nail polishes. I found that they took forever for me to dry, and I needed to use at least three layers in order to get it nice and opaque. So just wanted to kind of throw it out there. I do think that the colors are beautiful once you get them on the nails. But for me personally, I know that the owner said that a lot of other people haven't had this problem. Maybe I'm just like not the best at applying nail polish. I don't know. But for me, it took like an hour at least for these to dry. And that's kind of a little bit of a long time. This video is not off to a very smooth start. Anyway, I gotta say though, the nail polishes, not my favorites, but the eyeshadows are beautiful and I cannot wait to play more with these. Everything is sold as singles as well as in bundles, and if you do buy bundles, of course you're going to save a little bit of money. I also want to play with some stuff that I got from Ofra, because I got a huge PR package from Ofra. It was actually insane. Like, it was so many things, and I just want to kind of play with some of those as well. I'm already wearing the Samantha March collab bronzer, which I absolutely love so far. I think it's beautiful. I think the color looks really nice on me. It's definitely on the warm tone side, but I don't really mind that. Let's see, what do I want to do first? I guess let's put on a lip product, because I did get the Samantha March collab, like I said, and it came with a lipstick as well as a lip gloss. I'm gonna go ahead and put these on so we can see what they look like. So the lipstick is in the shade Story. I love this color. It looks beautiful. This is totally something that's right up my alley. And I also know that I really like the Ofra liquid lipstick, so I'm gonna go ahead and put this on. Oh, that is really pretty. That's actually more kind of mauve-y than I was expecting. I like that a lot. What a nice color that is. I'm not sure if I want to wear the gloss or not. I'm gonna let this dry and kind of maybe at the end of the video I'll pop this on so we can see what it looks like. I also want to use a little bit of this blush that I got as well, and when I used it the first time I kind of swirled both sides together, but I think this time I'm going to use just this side here. So let's see what this one looks like. I feel like this is just going to look really nice and not natural. That's definitely the wrong word. It's definitely nice and pigmented, but I feel like it's the kind of color that will pretty much go with like any eyeshadow look that I do. It's more of a neutral color, I think, is what I was trying to go for. But this is really nice, and I do really like the formula on this as well. The only thing that I don't really like about Ofra's products is honestly the white packaging. Like, I love the packaging itself, but the fact that it's white, like when I was playing with the stuff yesterday, I felt like everything was just looking really dirty after, and I don't know, it just annoys me a little bit. But it is definitely very nice and sleek, but the color, I kind of wish that it was just like black or something, I don't know. But isn't this such a pretty blush? I'm gonna do some freckles as well, I think, because I thought about doing that earlier and I just didn't. I'm going to take my Lime Crime freckle pen here and just do a little bit of freckles. I don't want too much, just like the tiniest amount right across the bridge of my nose and just a little bit on my cheeks as well. Outside of the highlighter from the Samantha March and Ofra collab, I also got two other highlighters from Ofra. I got Space Baby as well as Cloud9, which are the NYX Tutorials highlighters, and I've been wanting to try these for a very long time. I'm probably gonna use one of these after I'm done with the look, but I wanna decide what it is that I wanna do with the shadows first. So let's take a look at these now, because I have used, I think, five of these in my first look. The one that I definitely didn't use was the green, so I do want like the green to be the focus of this look, I think. I also kind of want to use one of these pinks because I haven't really touched them too much. So I'm thinking maybe I can do like a pink and purple crease and then do the green and maybe one of these like on my lower lash line or something like that. Could that be kind of fun? I don't know. Let me go ahead and find some palettes that I can use to just get some mattes down at least. So I think I'm going to use this Glam Light palette. This is the Paint Palette and Paint Pro Palette, I think it's called. So I'm going to use this for the mattes. First, I'm going to prime my eyes with my Natasha Denona eyeshadow base, which I'm actually running out of, and that makes me really sad because I totally forgot to buy a backup of this during their Black Friday sale. And now I have to pay full price, but it is what it is. I feel like I've been all over the place in this video already. Sorry if everything that I've said just doesn't make any sense. I'm gonna start with taking the green in the front portion of my crease and then do... Did I even say what I was going to do? Probably not. I'm gonna do a green and pink crease, so I gotta be very careful to not mix them in together too much because they are going to get a little bit messy. So I think I'm gonna use the green in the front portion and then use probably this shade right here because it's going to match very nicely to one of the shades that I am going to use on my lid. So I'm gonna start with the color lime. Gonna be kind of quick with the mattes here since these aren't really like the focus of the video per se. So I'm just gonna take that in the first portion of my crease here as well as the front portion underneath my eye. I'm taking this about halfway across and I'm making sure that when I get to the halfway point that I don't drag it out too much because I just want to put these colors right next to each other without really doing a lot of blending. Because like I said, it is going to get a little bit messy if you blend a green into a pink. Like I said, just going to pop that underneath my eye as well. This could definitely be a case of do as I say, not as I do, because this might end up turning into a very crazy and not very cohesive look here. But I'm gonna take the shade called Magenta. I think that's what I wanna use. That one is really pretty too. I think I'm gonna go ahead and take this one though. I'm gonna start packing on the outer corner of my eye here, or the outer crease corner, I should say. I think I'm also going to take these shades onto my lid as well, just because, like I was saying in the beginning, the shades are a little bit on the sheer side, so I think that if I put them on top of like the same color, they're going to pop a little bit more. Just making sure to really just tap gently right where the green kind of meets, because I do not want these to really blend in together too much. Also taking this underneath my eye and just meeting it up and blending out the outer corner of my eye here. Also, Happy New Year's. Like, it's so weird for me sometimes to remember that videos are going up in the future and not like in the present when I'm filming it. So Happy New Year's. I hope you guys had a good New Year's Eve, and I hope that 2021 is a better year for everybody, because it's really hard for it not to be, am I right? How many times do I have to say that I love Glam Light's mattes, because they just perform so well. So I was saying that I'm gonna take this on my lid as well, so I'm going to do that. I'm just gonna pack it on. It doesn't have to be like super precise or perfect here, but I just wanna have a little bit of a layer underneath those shadows just so they can really pop. Because otherwise they are going to look a little bit transparent. And if that is the look that you're going for, if you like something that's a little bit more sheer, then you could absolutely do that as well. But I just want to make sure that everything is looking nice and intense and opaque here. Oh, I just love this. This is actually kind of cool. I think this is going to work out. I'm just going to do the same thing with the green here. So my next step is going to be to put down some of my NYX Glitter Primer. I'm just going to pop that basically all over my lid, and then we will do the shadows over the top. So I'm just gonna take a little bit of this and just kind of pat that over where I want the shimmers to be. And then for the front portion of my lid, I'm gonna take the green one, which is called Glow Life. And I'm just gonna pop that right in the front here. Oh, it just looks so pretty. Like, these look so much better on the eyes than they do in a swatch, and I find that to be the case with so many shadows that are like this. Shadows that are a little bit sheer and like toppery-like, they just look so much better on the eyes. And I mean, obviously I'm using a primer here as well, which I didn't do when I swatched it, but just look at that. I mean, it looks like neon reflective goodness. It's just so pretty. And this is a beautiful, probably inner corner shade as well. Ooh, I love. Look at how pretty that is. That looks amazing. And then with the other side of my brush, I'm gonna take this one, which is called Glow with the Flow, and I'm gonna basically put that on the outer portion of my lid here. Just gonna pat that on where I want it to be, and these should blend okay in together. It's a little bit easier to blend shimmers in together that are sort of on the complementary side than it is to blend a matte into another matte. So this is a duochrome. This is a blue to pink is what it's looking like. That looks really pretty as well. Man, I kind of wish that I did a blue on the outer portion of my crease instead of a pink, because I didn't realize that this has such a strong blue shift to it, but it actually makes it blend nicer into the green because of that. But this is pretty cool. I like that. I feel like now I can use the Space Baby highlighter since this has a little bit of blue in it. I know that's a lot of things going on at the same time, but like I'm kind of a lot too, so it doesn't really matter. For my inner corner, I guess I will take a little bit of this yellow as well because I have it here. This one is in the shade Glow Ride. Gonna give this a little spray here of some Fix Plus just so we can get this nice and intense. And I already used this in my inner corner when I didn't film the look, and I loved it. Oh, it just looks so pretty. I love these shadows. These are so fun. And I feel like they're very unique to my collection. I don't think I have really any colors like this in this exact formula. Like, I feel like at this point, this is sort of the kind of thing that my collection needs. It needs things that are unique and that I don't already own, and I feel like I can say that about these. Next up, so Ofra sent me a bunch of their Fix Line eyeliners, and I used one of these in my Instagram tutorial. I used the green one in my waterline, and they're very, very, very creamy. They're almost on the liquidy side. They're very strange. I will show you the consistency of the green one at least, but I think I'm going to use probably the purple one. So you can see just how liquidy it is. It's very, very interesting. And I just want to kind of see like if it's going to perform better on my top lid than it does in my waterline. It was okay in my waterline, but it took a little bit of time to kind of dry down. So I want to try to use this one, which is a dark purple, just as my eyeliner today, just so we can kind of see how these look. Okay, so the consistency of this one looks a little bit different and maybe not as kind of liquidy and runny. So I'm interested to be trying this because this is a beautiful color that I don't really have in an eyeliner. So it's super creamy, and it's not the kind of texture that the melt ones have. The melt ones are very moussey, whereas these ones are just very, how would I explain it? It's almost like putting your brush into a pudding. That's kind of how it feels. So I'm just gonna go ahead and do a kind of thick line on my top lid here with this purple, and we'll see just how long it takes for this to dry. These are very, very easy to work with though, just because of how creamy they are, and they're very nice and opaque. So the more I kind of go over this, it's almost like it removes a little bit of what I already put down because it takes a little bit of time for it to dry. So maybe it's not that opaque upon first application, or like it goes on smoothly, but like when I drag my brush over it, it kind of removes a little bit of the product while I'm working on it. Like it's totally fine and it builds up very nicely, but just something to kind of mention. I really like the color of this though. I'm gonna go ahead and just wait for this to dry for a little bit. So definitely not the fastest drying eyeliner. I want to say it's been like 2 minutes now and it's finally like totally dry. So let's see. I'm going to curl my lashes and I want to show you a mascara that I got from Ofra as well because I was so impressed the first time I used it, and I don't usually get impressed the first time I use a new mascara, but this mascara is honestly amazing. Before I do that though, I'm gonna pop a little bit of this turquoise in my waterline. This is fresh from LA Girl. I don't know, I just felt like being very colorful today. So that's just what we're gonna do. So here's what the mascara looks like. This is called the HD Volumizing Mascara. And I'm so impressed by this. I don't even know what to tell you guys. I'll show you what like two coats of this will do compared to not having any mascara on at all. Like, look at that. Isn't that absolutely amazing? I think that looks so good. And that was so quick. It doesn't really need that much building up. And I can see this being like a rival to my Bad Gal Bang. And I didn't even know that Ofra had a mascara. So I'm just like kind of blown away by this, honestly. It just separates my lashes so beautifully. It gives them length. It gives them volume. Like, I'm honestly shook. I hate the word shook, but it really is the best way to just describe how I feel about this mascara because I love this. This is really, really nice. So I'm gonna go ahead and just finish off my eyes to the rest of my mascara, and then we can do some highlighter. Now let's dig into this highlighter. So this is the Space Baby highlighter, and it's kind of a like a light icy blue. So I'm curious to see how this is going to look on the face. I'm gonna use a very, very fluffy brush here because these are extremely intense and like metallic looking. And I don't really wanna have like too much of this. So I'm gonna be a little bit careful. This is a brush from Morphe, by the way. It's the Y14. This was all the hype when Laura Lee was like raving about this brush, and I bought it, and I really do like it for certain highlighters. It just depends. But a highlighter like this where I want a more subtle application, I definitely like this brush a lot. So yeah, you can definitely see it's more of a lavender. I feel like it's very, very icy. So if you're fair, I think that you would really like this. It's maybe a little bit too icy for what I like in my highlighters, but I think that the color is really cool. I mean, that looks really nice on camera, not gonna lie. Probably should have gone with a bit more of a cool tone blush to go with this. I feel like that would have really tied it together if I used like a pink blush instead. I think that the blush that I have on now, which is a little bit too just warm tone and neutral, just doesn't really go with this highlighter, but it's okay. I just wanted to try the highlighter still, so I do think it looks really, really fun. I'm just going to put a little bit of this on my nose as well. And I guess I will just finish off by popping on a bit of this gloss as well. So I don't want to make the doe foot dirty. So I'm just going to take a little bit of this on my finger here and just tap this over. Oh, so this is a blue gloss. Very interesting, very subtle though, but I like it. You could definitely kind of build this up and get a very strong blue intense shift. Actually, I knew that this had a bit of a blue shift. I just completely forgot. So this is going to be the completed look, I think. Am I missing anything? I think that's it. So I really liked everything that I tried today. I mean, all the Ofra products, honestly, that I received, I've been so impressed by. Like, I haven't tried a lot of things from Ofra in the past, so it was fun to kind of like dig into the brand a little bit more and like try more stuff. And don't worry, I will showcase this in more videos, and I also plan on moving forward at the end of each month, kind of do like a monthly review roundup and doing like favorites and fails and stuff like that, because I really enjoy watching other people do that, but I don't want to do it in a haul form where I have to like talk about everything that's come into my collection, because I feel like sometimes with hauls, I used to do them and it made me not want to use the products until I hauled them, and then sometimes it would just take forever and they would just like lay in a basket waiting for me to kind of like show them off. So I want to just do it in a way where I kind of like pick and choose the things that I do want to review that I feel like I have something to say about. So I will definitely mention the Ofra products in the, you know, monthly January, I guess, review roundup that's going to come at the end of the month or beginning of February. So that's going to be a new thing on my channel that I'm pretty excited about, because it's something that I've been kind of thinking about doing for a while. So yeah, also don't forget to check out Beauty Bar Baby. This collection is already available for pre-order. Remember, it is a pre-order, so it's going to take a little bit of time for it to ship and probably get there as well. But that's just what it's like to shop from indie brands, and these are also hand-pressed shadows and hand-mixed nail polishes. So just keep that in mind and give these brands a little bit of slack when it comes to time and stuff, because they do make all of their products and they do everything themselves. So that's going to be it for today's video. Thank you so much for watching. As always, if you're new to my channel, don't forget to subscribe, and I will see you in my next video. Bye.